Welcome to the Hyfindr Expo Highlights. Today I have Jake from Haskel with us today. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much for having me. Yeah.
Tell me, Jake, what innovation are you guys presenting?
Yeah, so today at the Breman H2 Expo, we're presenting our new HP systems. So these HP systems are the core component of hydrogen refueling stations. Mm-hmm. Hydrogen refueling stations consist of compression, storage, chilling in some cases, and dispensing. Okay. So the core bit of a refueling station is the compression. And we're recognizing more and more users all over the world just need distribution of the molecule.
Yeah.
So that's what we're offering. We're offering the distribution of the molecule via compression and the whole hydrogen refueling station. Okay.
And when you say HP, you mean high pressure?
High pressure.
High pressure.
That's
okay,
right.
That's
yeah.
Sorry, high pressure. For those of us not in the compression industry.
So we have MP and HP. So the MP series delivers gas at around 500 bars. That's our medium pressure series.
Yeah.
And then we also have the HP series that delivers gas at 1,000 bar at both 1,000 kilo and 500 kilo.
Okay. I know you brought a photo. Maybe you can just show us that one. Yeah. Is this at your stand?
Yes, exactly. Yes. This is our stand.
This container, is there?
No. Not the whole container. It wouldn't fit it in. It was a 40-foot container.
Ah, okay.
And I don't think ATEX would allow us.
Okay.
But yeah, this is the system that we're currently presenting. Yeah.
Well, what does it do?
Okay, so as I mentioned a moment ago, refueling stations are built up of compression, storage, and dispensing.
Mm-hmm.
They're the most critical parts. Without compression, you can't get the molecule into the end user's vehicle.
Yes.
Whether it's a vehicle, whether it's the grid, whether it's a truck, train, plane, you've got to compress that molecule.
Yeah.
And this really is the key component. So inside this system here, there's two H-drive compressors.
Yeah.
These H-drive compressors are variable. So for anyone that doesn't know what a compressor does, it takes gas from a known pressure, in this case 30 bar, and works on a ratio usually of 6:1. Ours is 6:1. So we take gas at 30 bar, we boost it on a ratio of 6:1, which gives us gas at 180 bar, and then we boost it again via a second stage compressor, allowing us to get gas up to 1,000 bar.
So essentially, it could come by tube trailers, or it could be in a storage at either 200 bar or 50, and this could get it up to 1,000 bar.
Exactly. Yeah.
And at what rate? I mean, people are always talking for the refueling stations, like how many vehicles can you do in a row, 100%. And these kind of things. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. So it's really interesting how that correlates. There's definitely a ratio between how many vehicles you need versus the compression and the storage.
Yeah.
Storage drives a lot of this conversation and available storage. We have to remember the way that hydrogen refueling works is that we boost gas to above the required pressure.
Yes.
So let's say a truck operates at 350 bar, we hold gas at 500 bar, and then we slowly decant that gas from 500 into 350 bar.
Okay. But you guys do the compression part, not so much the storage part. Or what's
no,
your
no,
specialty?
So we do the whole system as well. So this is a key component that we're presenting at this show because we're seeing more demand for compression.
Yes.
Okay. So compression, storage, and dispense creates a refueling station, and then what we're doing is essentially saying, look, if you just need compression, ideal for tube trailers. So if you wanted to refill tube trailers when you don't need all that storage, you don't need a fancy dispensing or chilling, we can get the gas and get it into that tube trailer very efficiently, around 1,000 kilo a day.
Okay. So I need to ask this because it's a personal question.
Yeah.
I've actually seen one or two refueling stations who were currently out of service because of something with the compressor. Can you tell us a little bit about the reliability of this, and are there guarantees that you guys are giving or something like that?
100%. So you've got various different types of compressors out there. The compressors that we supply are hydraulic, okay? They're oil-free, which essentially means that when you're compressing the molecule, there's no oil or moisture present when we're pushing that molecule in. There's been historic problems on refueling stations where they compress the molecule and moisture is getting into the system.
Mm-hmm.
That's one problem. There's lots of different types of compressors out there. There's diaphragmatic, there's reciprocating, there's liquid ring. The type that we offer is very, very controlled and it's variable. So I'm very confident that all of our compressors that we supply will last for 6 months in service before they need to be, the seals need to be changed, the system needs to be changed. But also the compressors themselves are designed in a way that they are much more effective than a lot of our competitors.
Mm-hmm.
And that's part of the IP that we offer, of course. So compression is quite a difficult technology to understand, and we've been doing this for 75 years now.
Mm.
Haskell itself has been known for compressors.
Yeah.
That's what we've always done.
Yeah.
And our value add is putting that compressors in HRS.
Yeah, and maybe on you mentioned the competition, so what would you say is a key differential when it comes to Haskell compressors?
So for us, it's the experience and knowledge. We've got it wrong and we've got it right.
Mm-hmm.
We've learned from historic problems. We're learning about how we can make the systems more effective.
Yeah.
Cascade calculations is incredibly important.
Yes. Yeah,
understanding how we cascade that solution from the compression. So what differentiates us is experience, knowledge. We've been doing this for 75 years now. And we're really experienced in the HRS sector.
Okay.
Over 30 operational as we stand.
Okay. Thank you very much, Jake. So as a matter of fact, we actually, as Hyfindr, did a video on the cascading of refuel.
Yeah.
Very interesting. So I can recommend to watch that. Well, thank you for coming over and letting us know about this. This is a very exciting technology, high pressure stuff.
Exciting.
It was an absolute pleasure to have you.
Yeah, thank you to you, Hyfindr too. It's been great.
Nice one.
Thanks. Cheers.
Thank you very much. Thank you for watching.